0 years on time because of the payment system. Right now, the Office of Education is relying on the Department of Health and Human Services. And so, to get anything done, it takes a long level of bureaucracy to even get something approved to advance causes that we need. Right at this point, hearing people are unable to speak for the deaf community. The only people that, there are many people at the Office of Deaf and Hearing that actually are deaf themselves. And hearing people are ill-equipped to speak and to advocate on behalf of the deaf community. At this point, advocacy and things like that is not going to be, it should be the Office of Deaf and Hearing's job to take care of blind issues. Unfortunately, they are not doing it. What we are proposing is a commission of an independent governmental agency, and they would oversee things like direct services. Oftentimes, you know, people are in need of things, you know, at a state level. And unfortunately, that's not happening right now. So the commission would allow us to be able to advocate for services, have direct services, and make sure that strong alliances are provided for other people.
We also just want to take a quick moment to recognize Justin from Representative John Pastor's Senator's office and Senator Weston with Ms. Jones as well.
So you mentioned other states have adopted things like the commission. Can you describe what other states do that you'd like to replicate in Wisconsin, and then maybe share some of the outcomes that you think we could experience in Wisconsin if we did this?
Well, let me give you an example. Arizona has a commission for the deaf and hard of hearing. They send out newsletters on a regular basis to let people know of the various things that are available and you can change some policy or laws within the state of Wisconsin. They provide workshops and training to people in the community. Unfortunately, we do not have any disabilities here in the state of Wisconsin because of the weak structure that currently exists in the Office of Deaf and Hard of Hearing. In the state of Arizona, they provide advocacy. Let me give you an example. Let's say an agency is supposed to be providing an interpreter. And let's say the interpreter is not following the code of professional conduct and is harmed in that particular situation. The commission in Arizona is allowed to provide representation to the deaf individual to make sure that effective communication is going on and their needs are being met. Fortunately, the people who are making decisions for deaf people are the ones making the decisions, and that is what we hope to eliminate here. Any other questions? And if I could just say one more thing. If you have any other questions, I know that we hopefully will have enough time to be able to talk about mental health services here in the state of Wisconsin. And with that, I will introduce another member of our community to talk on these issues. And here they were very familiar with
addressing issues, and this bill will also address it.
Hi, my name is Ron. My story may be a little sensitive, and I remember at a time in my life when I was coming up, and I was finding who I was. And during that process of going through that identity change, it was hard because a lot of people didn't understand me. I would go to counselors who were not deaf, and it wasn't the same. Having a counselor who is fluent in deaf culture and American Sign Language would allow me to sort of break out of my shell, because I know many people like myself have had thoughts, say, of suicide or of other serious events that can impede their lives. But we don't have outlets to directly go to, and that is why I support mental health services, direct services, through providers who are fluent in the DSL and deaf culture. So please support mental health for those who don't need help.
I take a look at this group of deaf community members, and you notice that we have people on the age scale from very young to much older. One of the things that we become very frustrated in seeing is getting services, whether it be in mental health or whether it be in a hospital, without an interpreter. And that is devastating. Oftentimes, when they try to, you know, have us read very long documents that are not in our language, to write things back and forth, we don't have those kind of things in every situation. Sometimes we'll be in the hospital for 5 days without any kind of communication. And that is very, very difficult for deaf individuals to persevere through. It is important that all services, mental health and medical, have some kind of interpreters, that we have communication. It is allowed to us by law, and we need to have something in place that allows enforcement of that at all aspects.
Thank you. Hello again. Marion. And again, I actually am a student. I'm looking to become a psychologist, so I'm studying that at university. And a lot of times, you know, we have practical experiences with through the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee. Now, it's a little bit frustrating, though, as a deaf individual going through this program. I look at Wisconsin, and we don't have a lot of mental health services. Actually, we don't have any mental health services for deaf people established. Somebody who can be a direct provider, somebody who has experience with the language and culture. I go to other states, and, you know, I don't want to have to go to another state just because the opportunity to work here in Wisconsin is lacking. So, again, my dream is to serve the community in a much-needed area that is lacking. So, I'm hoping just even for our, you know, community and my future
Thank you. video relay interpreter, which is through a small screen.